In this video, we'll talk about representativeness heuristic. Representativeness refers to the similarity of the description of a phenomenon to the stereotype. We use the representativeness heuristic when we ignore base rate. Let's look at a simple puzzle. Here is a description of your new neighbor. Steve is intelligent and shy. He doesn't seem interested in getting to know neighbors. He has a need for order and structure. He is very detail-oriented. Please rank the four occupations you see on the screen in order of the likelihood that Steve is in each of these fields. Use 1 for the most likely, 9 for the least likely. How do you evaluate the probability that Steve is engaged in a particular occupation? You are likely to see how similar the description of Steve is to the stereotype of professionals in different occupations. In other words, you make your judgment by evaluating the degree to which Steve is representative of, ignoring the probability of the resident's occupation in your neighborhood. We use representative heuristic to make judgment because probability is a vague concept to many people. We mostly don't calculate probability like statisticians do. To make a judgment, we make a mental shortcut by looking at how similar the description is to the stereotype. In some cases, there is some truth to the stereotype, such as young men are more likely than elderly women to drive aggressively. Another example is that you can take a representative heuristic when you decide whether it is a good idea to bring an umbrella during a trip to Seattle in spring. Like all heuristics, the representative heuristic promotes efficiency in decision-making by saving time and energy so that we can make a snap decision without thinking much. The problem with taking this approach to judgment of probability is that the representativeness heuristic can lead to serious errors when we are first, insensitive to prior probability, second, insensitive to sample size, and third, have a misconception of probability. That is, the stereotype is wrong and the base rate points to another direction. People who use the representativeness heuristic are susceptible to stereotypes. When we use limited information to fit people into stereotypes, we often make oversimplified perceptions, which can be negative and ignorant sometimes. The representativeness heuristic can lead to many other biases, such as affect heuristic and availability heuristic. Relying on the representativeness heuristic, some people think negatively about whole groups of people, like the stereotype of Muslims after 9/11. In education, a research study reported that teachers, both white teachers and teachers of color, had two stereotypes about students' math ability. The first stereotype was that boys' math ability was higher than girls. The second stereotype was that white students' math ability was higher than that of Black and Hispanic students. It is also false to stereotype African-American boys as disrespectful and habitually truant. Developing and sustaining intergroup contact is a potent tool to reduce prejudice and stereotype. In the United States, weapons are implicitly associated with African Americans. Are these implicit African Americans' weapon stereotypes weaker in areas with racial diversity? The answer is yes. across 351 U.S. metropolitan areas, the more racially diverse the neighborhoods are, the weaker the implicit African Americans' weapon stereotypes are. Moreover, the more dispersed the racial groups are in the neighborhoods, the weaker the implicit African Americans' weapon stereotypes are. In comparison, the less representation of minority racial groups are in the neighborhood, the stronger the implicit African Americans' weapon stereotypes are. In this video, we talk about the representativeness heuristic. Representativeness refers to the similarity of the description of a phenomenon to a stereotype. We use the representativeness heuristic when we ignore base rate. Now it is time for you to provide an example of the representativeness heuristic and reflect on how it influences the decisions made by you or the people around you.